Over the last 20 years, more than 20 actors, can you believe, have played the king of the jungle, Tarzan. Everyone has a favourite, but if you were a child of the 60s, chances are it was Ron Ely. Mm. Our very own Richard Reid sat down with Ron for this Australian TV exclusive.
The cheetah has grown to know one who is swifter. The lion knows one who is braver. Tarzan.
I gotta tell you, and I mean this in sincerity, you are still so handsome.
Oh, I was expecting that. because I do have a mirror at home.
You know. No, you are.
I mean, see for myself that that's not
true. It's true. It's true.
Well, we sure started off on the right note. Thank you. You're a great-looking guy yourself.
Well, thank you.
Okay, so we
got about you, though. It's not about me. It usually is, but now it's about you.
All right.
It was Ron Ely's chiseled manly features and tight muscular build that landed him the role of the iconic and always nearly nude jungle hero.
I'm afraid you're gonna find it a little uncomfortable, but you won't be in any position to complain when you're found, if you're found. Get them in there.
While Tarzan could swing from trees and wrestle with tigers, much of his appeal stemmed from his legendary loincloth. How did you manage doing all those scenes as Tarzan just wearing a loincloth? Were you ever self-conscious?
Never.
Never?
No. I mean, it's a bathing suit. I mean, it's like swim trunks. I actually didn't realize what the image was projecting. You know, I never thought of it as being sexy. That was the last thing in the world that occurred to me.
Ron, you were a sex symbol.
I didn't know that.
You didn't know it the whole time?
I never knew it. I never knew it. I didn't know why I was getting certain letters. If I had read all those letters back there, I'd have gotten a hint, I think.
Long before there was Magic Mike, there was Tarzan. Come on.
Yeah, there was.
And with all that swimming, swinging, and fighting, of course there was bound to be a few wardrobe malfunctions, right?
There were a couple of high dives that almost denuded me, but I'd catch around the knees.
Denuded you? That's a nice word. Is that a real word? Denude. Dude, you're denude.
If it's not, it is now. I just made it up.
An avid athlete and fitness buff, Ron adamantly refused to use a stunt double of any kind. And he sorely paid the price.
I had a lot of injuries, so most of the time I was recovering.
What was the most serious injury you had?
I had a fall, busted my shoulder and my wrist, and it was quite a high fall. First indication was that it had killed me because it knocked me so loopy I didn't move. But there were some with animals that didn't work out too well, and some with fire and some with high falls and things like that.
Oh, let me just get this, let me just reiterate this. Injuries because of animals, fires, high falls. Am I missing anything?
Well, no.
Always an animal lover, Ron relished working with wild beasts until the day one unpredictable tiger almost ended his career and his life.
I seem to recall you being in a wrestling match with a tiger?
Mm-hmm. I was trying to play with him at his level, which is a very tough level, a very harsh level. But trying to keep him happy so he didn't suddenly realize that here's a human that he could eat and have another meal.
I believe you were bleeding at one point.
Yeah, I was, yeah.
Yeah.
I was bleeding profusely from my ears, and I think my eyes were even... He socked me pretty good, you know. I mean, the tiger can do this and this. And I was not expecting this, the karate chop by the tiger. But no pun intended, ferocious.
As the unofficial king of the apes, Tarzan shouldn't have had a favorite monkey, but he did.
Cheetah, that's dirty water.
Loved that chimpanzee. Loved
really?
It. Oh, yeah. We'd show him a little trick, like, do this and get him to raise his hands, and then I'd go bang and fall over backwards.
Tarzan's awesome warning cry is known to every living creature in the jungle.
And then there was that yell. But if you're wondering how Studley Ron mastered that mucho macho call of the wild, get ready to have your Tarzan loving little hearts broken.
I faked it. I put on and put anybody's sound in there you want. That's the one thing I want to do. The reason is Johnny Weissmuller.
Yeah.
And then he did this incredible call. I understand he might have had a couple of drinks when he went in, so he just let go. And you can't improve on it. And they electronically mess with it. And how do you improve on that? I mean, how do you change it? You're going to make a different call? Going to make people get used to something that sounds different from that? Or are you going to try to improve that? You can't.
So in the beginning of the show, when they had the call, that was Johnny Weissmuller. That was not you.
No, that is still Johnny Weissmuller.
That's a little known secret that that was not you doing the Tarzan call.
Well, not to anyone who knows me, it's not.
Hollywood Show as well for giving us access to Ron. Richard, there were so many stars. What is the Hollywood Show really like?
Oh, you know, I absolutely love the Hollywood Show. We've been to two or three of them now. And, you know, there are stars. I mean, we talked to Doris Roberts, of course. You know, everybody loves Raymond.
Wow.
Lieutenant Uhura, Ron Ely, Joan Collins was there. No photographs too close, please, for Joan Collins. But I gotta tell you, you know, fame is such a fleeting thing, but it is so kind of intoxicating, and people who had fleeting fame want to hang on to it a little bit. Mm. Others who had big fame are still famous. Cloris Leachman, you know her, that actress? Mm-hmm. The line is around the block for her. It is just so amazing. I love it. I love it. And it's so great to have stars of yesteryear meet up with their fans who still love them, and they just get that adrenaline
This
going
is the thing,
again.
Because when everyone was talking about who's your favourite Tarzan, I was scared to say because this was the one I grew up on. I was so obsessed with this show. It was like part of my life. When I was coming home from school, I actually had to do the Tarzan call from across the street from my house.
Do it.
Okay. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Would come,
Tarzan
one, two,
call.
Okay, one, two, three. One, two, three.
Sounds like a frog in a blender.
Yeah. Don't call us. We'll call you.
Dogs in the neighborhood run down the street.
Yes.
Exactly the same. Can't tell the difference.
It was you, wasn't it?
It was.
Yeah, yeah.
I was
talented, Joe. So talented.